when Darth Vader dueled the Emperor's new cyborg apprentice. It came as a surprise to learn that in the Emperor's greed and lust for total power, he had backups. Replacements, should Vader ever weaken his resolve in the dark side of the Force. If ever Vader became less ruthless or less murderous, then the Emperor would put him down like a pet that he no longer wanted and simply pick up a new one. One of these replacements was known as Commander Karbin, a Mon Calamari soldier who had been cybernetically fitted with a droid body, just like General Grievous. Fueled by the envy of Darth Vader, Karbin would eventually challenge the Sith Lord, putting former Jedi Master Skywalker through a heated lightsaber duel that would challenge Vader, pushing him to his limits. That is this story. Just weeks after the destruction of the first Death Star at the hands of the brand new Rebel pilot Luke Skywalker, Darth Vader had tracked a band of Rebels to the remote planet of Vragus Vass. Having arrived alone, Vader was stranded on the planet when his TIE fighter crashed onto the planet's surface. The occupying Rebels assumed they could easily defeat Vader since he was all alone without his Imperial stormtroopers for support. However, the Sith Lord managed to kill over 1,000 Rebel soldiers and a wing of their armada, using only the Force and his lightsaber. Thinking that he would be stuck on this planet, battling rebel after rebel until the end of time, Vader was mildly surprised to see the arrival of an Imperial armada, seemingly here to assist him, but that only lasted a moment. Something was a little off about these ships and their troops. Vader, the usually staunch and composed figure of the Empire, was perplexed. Suddenly, he was surrounded by unfamiliar stormtroopers. A half Mon Calamari, half cybernetic creature marched over. Vader knew who it was.
Karbin,
he exhaled through his cold, metallic mask. He was there to please the Emperor any way he could, starting with taking Vader's personal mission of capturing Skywalker and Leia away from him.
It's not the Rebel Princess who will be put out of their misery here today. It's you, you withered old relic,
Karbin jabbed. As Karbin's troops moved in, enough was enough. Vader was taking both the infamous Rebels and Mon Calamari Imperial down. Smoothly force-pushing the incoming stormtroopers away, Vader ignited his lightsaber. Karbin's seemingly two cybernetic arms expanded into four. He ignited his four lightsabers in response, green, purple, and blue blades. Unfazed, Vader went straight in for the kill. His one red lightsaber against Karbin's four of multiple colors, the match seemed unfair. But that would only be to those who underestimate Darth Vader's strength. While Karbin continued to taunt him, the Dark Lord of the Sith concentrated his feelings on the Force. Vader's opponent wasn't eagle-eyed enough to clock what was happening. Vader was trading lightsaber strikes with Karbin, making the Mon Calamari think that they were on equal footing. But Vader was leading his opponent into an unfavorable position. Karbin realized too late. Karbin's confusion turned to a quick second of sheer panic as he realized that Darth Vader was about to bring down a huge statue right on top of him using his mastery of the Force. With no time to escape or retaliate, the massive stone structure came crashing down on Karbin in an explosion of dust and sand as Vader emotionlessly watched the crushing before his eyes. But there was no time for rest. As Karbin slowly made his way out of the rubble, Vader calmly approached his rival. In one swift move, he sliced off one of Karbin's robotic arms. The half-Mon Calamari commander screamed, not in pain, but anger. He used his remaining limbs to jump away from the brawl. Escaping to a nearby cave, Vader followed close behind Karbin. But there were more enemies of the Sith Lord hidden within than just Karbin. The voice of a distant ghost started to pester Vader. It was Kenobi, an old friend, a slain adversary.
Anakin, dreams pass in time. Be mindful of your thoughts, they'll betray you.
His former Jedi Master Obi-Wan Kenobi's words rattled through his head, making him forever guilty for his fall from grace. Although he dismissed them, the thoughts and voices no doubt distracted him. And that was just when Karbin chose to strike. Slicing right across Vader's back, the Dark Lord was finally on his back foot. Their lightsabers illuminated the dark chalk-red rocks, encapsulating them. Vader managed to defend and block the attack, but he wasn't winning the fight. He had been injured by Karbin. But there was more. The boy, Luke, had been distracting him. Vader was being pulled by a desire to be with his son. He thought he simply wanted to use the boy's power to overthrow his master, the Emperor. But there was more to it. The light side was calling to him. He was motivated by more than just rage and anger now. He was motivated by family, and it was making him weak. As they fought their way out of the cave and onto the precariously rocky ridge, Darth Vader relied more on his force powers than lightsaber-wielding prowess. Taking this as a sign of weakness, Karbin not only taunted Vader, but aggressively lunged at the Sith Lord, all four sabers spinning. But Darth Vader remained still, for he knew help was just around the corner. His trusted renegade scientist, Dr. Aphra, was about to land her ship right on top of Karbin. She smashed through the ridge, and Karbin plummeted into the sand below with rocks piling onto him. And it was a long way to fall. After Aphra ejected from her ship, Vader made his way down to the rocks to Karbin. He was dying, slowly. Barely being able to push his breath out of his caved-in lungs, Karbin whispered,
"This isn't just revenge for the Death Star, is it? This is something else."
Karbin wondered aloud, asking Vader's obsession with the boy who launched the proton torpedoes. There was a moment of silence. Vader quietly broke it with a simple phrase,
"You'll never know."
Then, just like that, the sky turned electric red with the light and crackle of Vader's lightsaber as he sliced Karbin in half. Standing alone on the jagged rocks, he felt a catharsis come over him. He'd inadvertently gotten a little too close to his feelings during the battle, something that he knew would derail him if not kept under control. But Karbin was right about one thing. It wasn't just revenge for the Death Star. If this fight with Karbin proved anything, it was that Vader needed to put his feelings under control. A worthy ally to the Empire and key enforcer, he was already feared enough. So to squander that by letting his guilt get the better of him would put his long-trained powers in serious doubt. In terms of Karbin, though, it was a daunting thought that the Emperor had seemingly unending numbers of secret apprentices waiting to replace Vader. Should the need ever arise, Vader would remember this, especially when bringing his son to the dark side.